Yeah, keep looking at, we've got some positive numbers here, so we might as well be optimists today. The average price for a gallon of gasoline has slid below $3.50 for the first time in a very long time, $3.49.5. You know, I could round up to $3.50, but I'm just going to say it slipped below $3.50. Where I am, $3.55 is the average of Michigan. And diesel has been coming down for a few days. It's down a dime since a week ago. So that whole thing about running out of diesel, not with us yet, but people are still concerned about supplies, especially with that rail strike that's on the horizon. Here to talk about this and everything else in the economy, Nick Hopwood, a certified financial planner, founder of Peak Wealth Management. Inflation, at least, has stopped going up. It's rolling over, but it remains pretty sticky. The Fed Reserve has signaled it will reduce the pace of interest rates going forward, but they're still going to increase them, it seems like. Nick, good to see you. Hope you had a good Thanksgiving holiday.
Thanks, Steve. I hope you had a great Thanksgiving as well. Yeah, it does seem like they're going to raise rates in December, but by less than they've been doing before.
So what are you expecting? A half a point? A quarter of a point? What are you hearing? What's your finger on the pulse of the world tell you?
The figures show a 99% probability of a 50 basis point increase in December.
Which would be a half a percent for folks out there. Now, that's not going to help people that are trying to buy a house or pay off their credit cards, because it still means an increase in interest rates. But at least it levels off. People can begin to plan where they're going to be. Inflation was at 7.7% last month. We'll have new numbers here in a week or so. It feels like things are fairly level, but it doesn't feel like things are getting any cheaper. That's for sure, Nick. And so we head into the holiday season with some uncertainties, don't we?
We do. But, you know, Black Friday was looking pretty good. With rates leveling off here, it looks like mortgage rates have stopped increasing. We're probably 6.5% down from 7. And money market rates are continuing to look very good as the Fed has raised rates. So the savers have been rewarded. Investors have been punished. But I'm optimistic looking forward for investors, particularly in fixed income.
Well, investors have been punished. However, we talked about this just before you came on today. Since about mid-October, there's been a pretty good run on the market, a mini run, if you will. The Dow's now at 33,850. The NASDAQ is at almost 11,000. The S&P at almost 3,960. So a lot better numbers than we were looking at not that long ago.
Absolutely. You know, we still are looking at that mid-October low for the Dow and S&P and NASDAQ, but we've had a nice bounce, as you mentioned. And what's interesting when you look, when you look under the hood, is how much better the Dow has done compared to the S&P and NASDAQ. Remember, the Dow has made up a lot of these blue chip value type names, whereas the S&P has been so heavily tilted toward technology, similar to NASDAQ, over the last few years. So we're getting a turn in the market, if you will.
Right. So a turn in the market. So I guess my question is then, did we bottom out? Because that was always the question. Had we hit bottom? I mean, if that was the bottom, it wasn't very far down to me. I've seen and felt what seemed like a lot worse crash, and we didn't really have a crash per se. And so was that it?
Well, we don't know, but it was down 27% from peak to trough, Steve. So in an average recession, you're in the low 30s. Is this an average recession? Well, we don't know. We don't know if we're in a recession or not. The data is very mixed. In fact, the GDP is looking good again if you look at the third and fourth quarter. However, the yield curve, which economic junkies like myself like to look at, is the most disturbing since 1981. So the question
is,
What does that mean?
Because here's the thing. Because here's something I've been talking about this week. For example, there was a company called United Furniture, I think was the name of the company in North Carolina, just before Thanksgiving, sent out an email just after midnight laying off all 2,700 of its employees. They built furniture. They're all done because their inventory built up because there was great demand during the COVID pandemic and the year after. But then interest rates have gone up. A lot of people buy furniture on time, you know, over time. And so therefore it crashed, wiped them out. I've seen a lot of other big layoffs from other companies, big layoffs. That's a little disheartening. What do you make of it?
Well, you know, when you're looking at an isolated case like that, you got to look, you got to question the management. But I don't know anything about that case, so I'll give them a pass. But it is disturbing, and we've seen a lot of headlines from other companies, as you mentioned, big layoffs. However, overall, we're still seeing job increases month after month with hundreds of thousands of new jobs. So that's one of the positive data points. The inverted yield curve, as you mentioned, which simply means that short-term rates are higher than long-term rates, is telling us that the market believes that the Fed is doing a good job to reduce inflation and that inflation will come down. Or it means that we're headed for a recession. So if we look back to 1981, when it widened out this wide, that was the type of situation where the Fed did cause a recession, but it did break the back of inflation. So it could be both.
Well, I guess we'll have to keep an eye on it. Nick Hopwood, certified financial planner, founder of Peak Wealth Management. You can find him online, Peak Wealth Management. Nick, we will keep an eye on it. I feel like there's still time to invest. 30 seconds. What would you do to be safe today and plan for the future? 30 seconds.
Well, to be safe today, you've got money markets at 3.5%, much better than a bank rate at 0.05. Fixed income looks very attractive at these levels in the 4 and 5% range for the future. And hey, if you want to be aggressive, why not buy the dip? Market double down, down double digits always has been a good option in the past.
All right, Nick, greatly appreciate it. Nick Hopwood, founder of Peak Wealth Management, always insightful. Thank you, Nick.
Thank you, Steve.
There you have it. A lot of different factors going to the economy. No, it's not this or that. It's this and this and that over there and a couple of other things thrown in just for spice. Always appreciate Nick's input. We'll take a break here on the Steve Gruber Show, and I'll be right back.